and great balls of fire. Mr. Jerry Lee Lewis, Round Bear Trail, and sit down beside me. Good to see you.
Oh, my goodness me. Have you any idea how many times you've done that number, sir?
I would say at least 300 billion times.
I'd say 300 billion times. A great hit for you.
Terrific. Thank you, sir.
Hey, you've come to Ireland to record an album and to write a book. Tell us more.
Well, that's what they say. Probably most of that is right. We intend to do an album here with some people. That it's been 8 years since I've been in the studio, and I'm very serious about this new album and getting back into the studio and seeing if I can really do it again. And it remains to be seen, but we're in Dublin, Ireland to do it. So if it can't be done here, I don't think it can be done anywhere.
Well, why Ireland, Jerry Lee? Why Ireland?
I don't know. There's an atmosphere in this city that is, I would say, like where I used to live in Faraday, Louisiana. And it's a certain something that, I don't know, like a God-blessed feeling, like a place where you could raise a child, you could meet people that are very sincere, and people that will admire and desire your music and appreciate it. I don't know. I don't really know how to explain it, but apparently I have some Irish in me.
You're kidding.
Wouldn't joke a bit.
Wouldn't joke a bit.
You don't know where they're from. You don't know where what the family connection is, but feel at home here. That's what
I really do.
Good.
It's a certain atmosphere I can't explain. It's just, I'm happy. I'm just happy in the city here, and I want the world to know it.
Very good. And do you want to do a bit of scribbling as well?
Well, I'm just a scribbling, but that's about what I do anyway. But as long as I scribble right, I might scribble out something.
Very good.
I don't know.
Now, I want to know, and I never got a satisfactory answer, why are you called the killer?
Now, that is pretty easy to explain. When I was in childhood at school, in grammar school, one day, I was about the fifth grade, I was walking across the school campus, and a friend of mine whom I grew up with called me. He said, "Hey, killer." And I said, "Are you talking to me?" He said, "Yeah, you, killer." I said, "Well, okay." And so I started calling him killer, and he started calling me killer, and we haven't really ever killed anything.
It's
time, maybe.
That's the way it's done. Now, I know that you claim to be king of rock and roll, and I want to know, why do you think you should be named king of rock and roll?
Well, that is very debatable. I guess if I'm king of rock and roll, it's just, you are what you are. I mean, I have been told that. I've heard that Elvis was king of rock and roll.
That's
which,
right.
I never disputed it. And I've heard a lot of people say, "Jerry Lee, you're the true king of rock and roll." I wouldn't ever want to really be called king of rock and roll or king of this. Maybe king of trying to do a song.
Yeah.
Or get, you know what I'm trying to say? I'm not king of anything. I think Jesus Christ is king. But I guess if you find a king of rock and roll, if you like to beat like a whole lot of shaking going on, which we're going to do for you in a little while.
That's right.
I think you'd call that maybe the king record of rock and roll.
It sure is. It must be one of the great records of rock and roll. It must be one of the great numbers indeed. Now, you're also doing a tour here now. In April, I know you're going to be in the Gaiety Theatre on the 5th and 6th of April.
Right, yes.
Belfast on the 22nd, Castlebar on the 23rd, and Cork on the 25th. You'll get a terrific welcome in all of those places, Jerry Lee, I can assure you. Do you still enjoy doing the live gigs?
Yes, sir, I do, much more than ever. I enjoy working, playing the piano, singing my songs with my fans, for the people that come to see me, pay to see me. And for some reason tonight, I'm a little bit nervous. I don't know why.
Why are you nervous? You're not nervous.
I guess it's because I'm facing such a beautiful audience. And
don't mind him. He says that to every audience. Don't you worry. That's what he does. You really enjoy doing the live gigs and making contact with an audience and have them get up and do some rock.
Yes, sir. I'm a whole lot of shaking going on.
You were going to be a preacher once.
Oh, I was.
Where did you go wrong, Jerry Lee?
Well, I just didn't figure I was on the right path. I was preaching. I preached for 3 years, and I turned 20 years old. I backed out of preaching because I just didn't think what I was preaching, I was not living exactly up to what I was preaching. I didn't think anybody else was. But I think you've hit on something now that is really the true Jerry Lee Lewis, I would say. And I don't know. I wanted to do what I wanted to do, and it was boogie-woogie, boogie-woogie rock or whatever. And everybody tries to confuse me. Why aren't you a preacher, or are you a sanctified Christian? I would say yes, and I'm a very Christian-minded person.
Yeah. From your folks.
Sir?
From your folks. They were religious people.
Yes, sir. Yeah. My family was. That's right. Raised in a Pentecostal church.
Right.
Assembly of God Pentecostal Church.
Now, Jerry Lee, you had an extraordinary amount of tragedy to deal with. One of your sons died accidentally drowning. Another son died as a result of a car accident at 19. One of your wives died in a drowning accident. Another died of an overdose. And you had several serious stomach operations for ulcers and so on. Were you told that you hadn't long to live at one stage?
Sir?
Were you told that you hadn't long to live at one stage?
Yes, sir. I was... Well, I was put in the hospital at one time and was given like 5% to 100 that I would not live, you know. And there's just no way I could live. The doctor told me, Jerry Lee, you don't have a chance.
He told you that?
He told me that. And I said, well, I believe I have. And it went on for about 3 months, and that's how long I stayed in the hospital, in intensive care. And I was as close to dying as any man has ever been. And it was quite an experience. And it really got me on the spot.
Well, you're looking good. You're looking good. For a guy who is so close to death's door, you're looking good.
Well,
and you made a lot of friends all over the world with your rock and roll and your songs and your performances.
I still do religious songs, too.
Do you?
Yes, sir.
You include those in every show, do you?
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
I never leave God out of my show. I identify with the Supreme Being.
Good. You know, when you were younger with a whole lot of shaking going on, now you're an older man and a father, they used to say to you that you put a lot of young people on the wrong road with those sort of songs, that were sort of rock and roll.
Oh, brother, you got some questions tonight for me.
You know they did.
Yeah, they did.
They did say that.
They still do.
Yeah, they said it about Elvis as well, for heaven's sake.
Well... That's true, but there's a lot of difference between... Well, you know how to ask this question. Elvis and I were great friends.
Yeah.
But when I first met Elvis Presley, we had met at Sun Records, and he was walking out the front door after we had sang a few songs together. And I said, by the way, Elvis, I'd like to ask you one question. He said, yeah, what's that, Jerry Lee? I said, if you die, do you think you'd go to heaven or hell? And he said... Jerry Lee, don't you ever, ever, ever ask me that again. Never. I said, no problem. I didn't.
Whatever did he mean, do you know?
Well, it scared him to death, I guess. But he called me up several times just before he died, and he wanted me to come out and talk with him. He said he wanted to talk on those terms again. And I never did go. I should have, but I didn't. And but that's history. And, but
well, I guess he knows now.
I believe he probably does.
Right now. Right now. Listen, go over to the piano there. Go over to the piano and do a whole lot of shaking going on for us. One of my great favorites, all right?
Yes, sir.
And I hope it'll be a long time before you join. Jerry Lee Lewis, ladies and gentlemen. Jerry Lee Lewis. Whole lot of shaking going on.
Thank you so much.
You saw a living legend of rock and roll. Kenny Lovelace there on lead guitar and their own Johnny Drummond on bass, young Michael Buckley on sax, and Desi Reynolds on drums. And Jerry Lee brought along a cassette for everybody in the audience of his own stuff. Thoughtful of. Little cassette for all of you. And he is in Dublin and Belfast and Castlebar and Cork
right through April, and it's wonderful to have him tonight because he was part of our growing up. He was part of all of that thing and making it come round again, and the young kids are cottoning on to what he's doing, and it's good to see him. All right, after that, we'll take a break. Come back to us after this. Thank you.